The company intends to preserve and pass on technology to the next generation. Basically, they are supporting this DIY community in a certain way, and I definitely understand and support their notion.
This video was not sponsored. Products were bought for personal use and there is no conflict of interest. Actually, it is in the shape of a box. How interesting.
So, let's get in. Ooh, trippy.
A business card of some sort? Wonder if there is a shower cap inside. It's full of candy and stickers. The reason we got this kit is to learn more about the FPGA technology and how it works. How it can be applied in different applications. Like for example now, it is used to create HDMI output for our old DMG Game Boy. And it turns a Game Boy, like this, into a console. What else is there? The HDMI out PCB? This is the most important component. Very nice. And let's see how it works though. And there is the PLA case.
HD Retro game box. Nice touch. And then here we go. I don't know how you do that with a 3D printed case, but it's really impressive.
And here comes the game controller connector. Was I supposed to get one separately? I thought it was included. Let's follow up on that. So, to be continued. Now, let's get to it. To use a medical analogy, this kit is to the Game Boy what titanium leg prosthetics is for handicapped. It turns a broken game into something much better than what it used to be. But, as you might have guessed, it requires parts of the original Game Boy as well. So, if you have a damaged unit with intact motherboard, do not throw it away. It might just be able to get its second life. Here we see the sturdy one-piece ABS plastic case. This will become more important later. Instructions direct us to file down the extrusions all around the PCB board and to unsolder the battery terminals, but we find it just so much easier to clip them off. And here is the consolizer case with a 3D printed cartridge holder and the internal spacer. At this point, brainstorming to figure out how to fit the DMG motherboard into its place. The main obstacle proved to be the mechanical off switch. I had to file it down on both upper and lower sides just to be able to fit through the designated gap in the case. Next we remove one of the daughter boards and short two of its terminals. The next daughter board is the stereo headphone jack socket. We analyzed the prospects and logic confirmed keeping this one should not cause damage to the hardware. So against the instructions, this is the creative DIY input that we propose. Here we can see the fitted DMG board with shorted pins and an already attached HDMI audio extension. For better or worse, this is a very tight fit. On the consolizer PCB, one also needs to remove a resistor. And for stereo audio, attach a connection from the DMG board. The heart of this board is the Xilinx Spartan 6 FPGA chip. Seems like a very complex board, something a two-man operation would have hard time to pull off. So, I'm surprised and impressed. The next thing to attach is the controller socket with its daughter board, which just arrived, so now we are able to complete this project. It has a nice black finish, and again, does not look like a DIY component. It's very impressive. After everything was put in the housing and the two boards got connected, at this point we were trying to find out how to place the headphone socket. So we decided to cut some hole on the right side of the housing and hot glue this little guy into position. Game is in, controller plugged. We managed to enter the menu on the consolizer board, but nothing is being loaded. What might be the reason? We did almost everything to instructions. We were not really getting it at that point. And by next morning...
It works! When the audio jack is plugged in, audio comes through the headsets. Sometimes it's finicky. When I play with the cover, then suddenly we have audio through HDMI as well. Beautiful!
The aesthetics of this kit is very unique. And if it was its main function, we would say it gets 10 out of 10. But, as we always do, we have to sacrifice a bit of beauty for better functionality. Also, devised a workaround to prevent damaging the DMG motherboard during cartridge removal. The original DMG had a very hard case, which meant cartridges could be pressed against it. This housing is, however, rather soft, so this is what we came up with. Here we are investigating whether HDMI audio output is still linked to the headphone jack. As we see, it crackles while headphones are playing music. Unplugging headset made no difference. Some more testing we ran definitely confirmed that plugging a jack in the socket does not influence and also does not turn HDMI sound off. The two work independently.
Guys, do you remember? This is my 128 in one cartridge. And this time, for some reason, sound is only coming through the headset. We solved it. This is the reason why I kept the audio jack. And I recommend you to do the same, guys. Keep the audio jack. Because through the audio jack, you can actually attach your entire home audio system to it. There was another guy demonstrating his remote controller with Alleyway. Again, sound only comes through the headset. Sounds working! What happened? Press B or A.
For us, it is of utmost importance to enable sound, as sound is almost half of the experience and is going to play a role in some of our future projects and demos we plan to use on this device. In terms of image quality, this kit allows for a 480 to 720 HD resolution. For us, the 480 resolution turns out to be the most optimal. Higher resolution seems to bring nothing for pixels of this size. It won't make the image any sharper, much rather just shrink the display area. An unadvertised advantage of consolizing this handheld was that the SNES port allows for a larger variety of controller devices. For example, it allows some of the space shooters to be played with the actual joystick. Very unique experience, definitely worth trying out. So after a bit more than a week of testing, we have formulated some opinions and grew into liking this beast. It does what it promises more or less. It looks impressive with the PLA case, which is stylish, but a little bit finicky and not the most stable nor hardest of the materials to use for a consolizer case. On the right side, we housed a headphone socket, as we noticed earlier adopters were already complaining about HDMI audio output. So we thought, why disable the possibility to output audio if it was originally already provided for? And boy, we were right about that. The socket works 100% of the time, whilst HDMI audio is very whimsical. Another advantage of using a jack is that we can use the original volume wheel on the DMG board. At the beginning, when no DMG content was read by the consolizer, we had to realize there was a disturbance inside the housing. It was our own fault, as we did something unorthodox by installing the audio socket. But kudos to the company, as reaching out to them, we got a quick assessment and reply within a couple of minutes, which of course helped us think it through, and with their help, we made it work. This was of course our fault, as on the inside we had components crammed up, pushing against each other. Therefore we had to remove the internal spacer and the screws. The spacer was anyways more of an obstruction than a necessity, we feel. The top part of the case turned out to be quite tight, so we filed down the two edges, and now cartridges come out and go in easily, and they are only caught by the cartridge reader.
Yeah, you also think so?
But that's basically expected of a DIY kit, right? You basically just mod it as you like. We understand why some of the features were not really improved upon. The company is probably putting all their effort into a newer Game Boy Advance kit, which actually also plays original DMG content. So maybe, if you're interested in a more consumer-ready product, you might opt for that kit. We are, however, pretty happy with this one as well. It is a very cool and easy DIY project. One learns a lot on the way. There is also support from the side of the company itself.
Take care, stay curious, and I catch you again next time. Bye bye.